Hello everybody, today we are going to start new lesson, that is construction. Okay, see here, we have seen some basic concepts that how to construct 30 degree angle, 60 degree angle, 90 degree angle, 120 degree angle. Okay, how to construct without protractor or how to construct with protractor, that such type of examples we have seen in class 5th, 7th and 8th also. Okay, so now we are going to see some more different constructions. Okay, so initially we will take some basic concepts. Okay, so here one basic example I have taken. Okay, so that we will see and we will go ahead. Okay, so here what is first question? See, draw a line segment of length 6.6 centimeter, bisect it and measure the length of each part. Okay, very simple question. Here it is given 6.6 centimeter. Okay, 6.6 centimeter. So when you will take in notebook, that time take exactly 6.6 centimeter. Okay, when we will bisect, that time we will get half of this, means 3.3. Okay, so but now 6.6 is very short distance for me, so I am taking more distance. Okay, but the procedure is same. Okay, so now I am doing here that construction, that is, see here, they have told us draw a line segment of length 6.6 centimeter. So I am taking here a line segment. Okay, so we will give here name AB. A and this is B. Okay, so AB is suppose 6.6 centimeter. Okay, now what they have told us, bisect it and measure the length of each part. Okay, so here see, we know the procedure of bisection of a line segment. Okay, so what we will do here, we need to take, see, this is AB. Okay, AB is, this is distance of AB. Okay, this is approximately half distance of AB. Okay, so we need to take more than half distance. Understood? Okay, so with the help of this distance, we need to take here one arc. Okay, at the same time downside one arc. Okay, now with the same distance, okay, we don't have to change the distance, with the same distance from the point B, we need to put here one arc, and from again here we will take one arc. Okay, now here you will get two intersection points. Okay, that arcs are intersecting to each other, here one, so you will get two different points. Understood? So this is one point. Okay, and this point and this point. Okay, so we have to join both the points. Okay, so now here I am doing that. Okay, so here we got that intersecting line. So suppose now here we can give P and here Q. Okay, so due to PQ, line AB is bisected. Okay, now see, if it is 6.6 centimeter, then you will get here definitely this is 3.3 and this is 3.3. So here intersection point I am giving here O. Okay, so definitely this AO and OB are same. AO and OB are same. So you can cross check your answer with the divider. Okay, so here see, if I am doing this, I am taking this distance AB. Okay, and then I will match with this point. Okay, so you will get exactly same. So this way, this is the procedure of bisecting a line segment. Understood? So more than half distance we need to take, and we can bisect that. Okay, so everybody knows that. So this was the one basic example I have taken. Now see, here we need to write steps. Okay, so you can write steps in short, that is steps of construction, whatever you have done, that only you have to mention in proper way. Okay, so first step, what we have taken, take a line segment AB with the given length. Okay, so take line segment AB that is given AB with length 6.6 centimeter, okay, 6.6 centimeter, whatever, or given length also enough. Second step, what we have done here, take more than half distance on line segment of line segment AB, okay, take more than half distance of line segment AB, okay. Then third step, what is third step, we have to take arc on both the sides from point A and point B, okay. So take arcs on both sides of line segment AB, okay, from both points, that is point A and point B. From this we have taken one arc upside and downside of the line segment AB, and from point B also we need to take arc upside and downside. It will intersect, okay. So finally what we have to do, join the points, intersection points, okay. And finally what we have to do, measure from the intersection OB and OA, okay, join intersection point, and where intersected there you have to give O or any other letter you can give, and then measure OB and OA. So definitely we will get the same distance, equal distance, okay. So this was one basic construction which we have seen already, but once again I have taken, okay. Okay, see here, our second problem is using a protractor, draw an angle of measure 128 degree. With this angle as given, draw an angle of measure 96 degree. Okay, so here we have to prepare angle of 96 degree from the 128 degree. Okay, so now here first they have told us using a protractor, means here we can use protractor, using a protractor draw an angle of measure 128 degree, okay. So first we will do that procedure, that is 128 degree we need to prepare. So here I am taking that, we need one line segment, okay. So from this 128 degree, okay, so here I am taking that one point A. So from point A we will take angle 128 degree, okay. So this is protractor, so with the help of protractor we are going to find out now angle 128 degree, okay. So this is 90 degree, this is definitely more than 90 degree, so 120 and 130, okay, 25, 26, 27, 28, so 128 is here, okay. With the help of lead pencil you will get exactly point, understood. So now this point we have to join here, okay, we need to join here, then your 128 degree angle is ready, okay. So this angle is 128 degree, this angle is equals to 128 degree, okay. Now from this angle we have to prepare 96 degree, okay. So now see here, A, here I am giving B, this is I am taking here C, okay. Now this angle is 128 degree, okay, got it everybody. Now what we have to do, we have to find out 96 degree angle from this, okay. So we must know how to prepare, we must know the flow of construction, okay. So see here, suppose rough work we are going to do, then what we will do, suppose I have taken here 128 degree, this is 128 degree, if I will take a bisection of, I will take bisection of this angle. Okay, so 128 degree will be divided into two equal parts, equal angles. So that is half of 128 is 64. Okay, so this also 64. Okay, so 64 degree and still some more part of this angle is needed. Okay, so half of 64, suppose we will bisect 64 once again, this angle, this 64 degree angle we will keep as it is, and this 64 we will divide, then what I will get here, 64 will be divided, then this will be 32 degree and this will be 32 degree. Okay, so now suppose I will do addition of this both angles, 64 plus 32, 4 plus 2, 6 and 6 plus 3, 96. So this is our required angle, this is our required angle. Okay, so first here we need to bisect this angle, so you will get angle, this 128 degree will be divided into two equal parts. Okay, so that I am going to do here now. Okay, so now here with the help of compass I am going to do that construction now. Okay, so here bisection of this angle, so from this you need to take with convenient radius, we have to take one arc which will bisect, which will intersect, not bisect, which will intersect both AC and AB in two different points. Okay, so here I am giving, that is, this is P and this is Q. Any letter you can use for this. What we have done, with the convenient radius we have to take an arc which will intersect AC and AB in two different points, that is P and Q. Why I am telling you this? Because afterwards we have to write constructions and we need to write justification also. Okay, we have to prove this. So now this is intersected in at point P and Q. Okay, now what we are going to do, actually what we are going to bisect angle CAB, angle CAB we are going to divide into two equal parts, that is bisection of angles we are going to do. So from this point I am going to take more than half distance here. Okay, more than half distance. And then we will make one arc here. With the help of same distance, we are going to put one more arc here. Okay, more than half distance, that side arc, with the help of same distance, you will take here. If you will change the distance, then you will not get exact construction. Okay, there will be error. Okay, so now this point, intersection point, and this we are going to join with the point A. We are going to join to with point A. Okay, so now see, angle CAB is divided into two equal parts, two equal angles. So this angle and this angle will be same. Okay, both the angles are same. Okay, now just now I told you this is half of that, that is 64 degree. 64 degree. Now we are going to bisect this angle with the help of same procedure. We are going to bisect this angle with the help of same procedure. So now then you will get, this will be divided then 32 degree, 32 degree, because this is now 64 degree and this is 64 degree. Suppose I am giving here name N. Okay, so CAN and BAN angles are equal, 64 degree. Okay, now CAN we are going to bisect with the help of same procedure, that is you can use the same arc, or if you want you can make a different arc, no problem. So with the help of same arc, if I am going to take distance, then I will get the same. Suppose here this distance I have taken, here it will intersect. So I am using the same arc, from this I am making here one arc and from this point I will make here one arc. Okay, so again this intersection point I am going to join, this intersection point I will join here at point A. Okay, so again if you will observe this angle, this angle and this angle will be same. So this is 32 degree, half of 64, and this is 32 degree. Okay, so this is 32, this is 32, and our required angle is C. This is 32 degree and they have told us 96 degree. We want 96 degree. So 64 plus 32 degree is 96 degree. Okay, so this is our required angle, this is our required angle, understood? This angle is required, so you can show this way. So now here I can write here any name, here I am taking M. Okay, because we are going to write as steps of constructions, Now this is required angle MAB is 96 degree. Got it everybody? So steps of construction, Okay, so first step, what we have done initially, take ray AB, okay, then second step, what we have done, from point A with the help of protractor, from point A, take angle 128 degree, which is given, okay. So from point A with the help of protractor, construct angle 128 degree. Okay, then what we have done? 128 degree angle we got. Okay, after the construction of angle BAC, what we have done? Take the bisection of angle BAC. Okay, so bisect the angle BAC, angle BAC. Okay, when you have bisected angle BAC, that time it is divided into two parts, that is BAN, we can write here angle BAN is equals to angle CAN, is equal to 64 degree. 128 is divided into two parts. Okay, now fourth step is bisect angle CAN, angle CAN. Okay, when you will bisect angle CAN, that time what you will do, NAM is equals to CAN. Bisection procedure I am not writing here because you know that. So here we can write NAM is equals to angle CAM is equal to 32 degree, because again 64 is divided into two parts. Okay, so this is 632 degree, this is 32, this is also 32. So MAB, our required angle is 96 degree. So BAM, so finally our required angle is BAM. Take angle BAM. Okay, why BAM? Because 64 degree, that is angle BAN plus angle NAM, is equal to 64 plus 32, that is 96 degree. Okay, so our required angle is angle BAM. Okay, if you want, you can increase some more steps, or you can write only important steps in that. Okay, so now next, if I want to justify how this angle is 64 degree, 96 degree, so that we can write. So here see, whatever we have taken, that only those steps we have to write there. So BAN, here we have taken angle first, what is there? Angle BAC, is equal to 128 degree. Angle BAC is 120 degree, which was required, given angle. So we have taken that. Then bisection of angle BAC, that is BAN, is equals to CAN. Angle BAN is equals to angle CAN is equal to 64 degree. Okay. Bisected angles. Okay. Again, NAM is equals to CAN. NAM is equals to angle CAM is equal to 32 degree. Again bisected. Okay. So now after this, our required angle is BAM. BAM is equals to angle BAN plus angle NAM. Okay, so BAN is 64 degree plus 34 degree. So 64 plus 32, 96 degree. So this is the justification. Understood? So three things we have done. First, we have to construct the given figure. Okay. Then steps of constructions and then justification. Okay. So see here, steps of construction. When you will start a construction, that time you must know how to do that. Okay. Then only you can bring on the paper. Okay. So see carefully and do this in your notebook. Okay, see here, next construction is construct an angle of 90 degree at the initial point of a given ray and justify the construction. Okay, see here once again I am reading question. Construct an angle of 90 degree at the initial point of a ray and justify the construction. Okay, so here first we need to take a ray. Okay, so I am going to take that is okay. So here suppose I will say here this is O and this is A, ray OA, OA. Now what they have told us, construct an angle of 90 degree at the initial point of a given ray. This is initial point. Okay, this is initial point. Understood? Ray and justify the constructions means here we have to prepare a 90 degree angle. Okay, so now here see, we have seen this also. Okay, suppose you will extend this line and you will make arc both the sides and you can construct here 90 degree. But now we are going to do with some different method. Okay, so see here carefully. We are going to do here one arc, okay, with convenient radius from point O. Okay, so from this I am going to make one arc with convenient radius. Okay, so I am doing here that arc which is intersecting ray OA at a point, we will give that point C, this point is C. Okay, now from with the help of same radius, whatever radius we have taken for this to make this arc, with the help of same radius we have to mark on the arc. Okay, make a point, fixed point, and make a arc here. Understood? So now here you got one point, you have one point. That point, suppose I am giving here name M. That point is, we will say this point is M. Okay, now with the help of same radius, with the help of same radius we are going to make one arc. Okay, this is not enough, so I am increasing that because still the radius is same. Okay, what we have done, we have taken one arc with the help of same radius, we have to take one arc on the same, okay, curve. Again with the help of same radius you will take one arc here. We will take one arc here. Okay, now we will give here name P. This is point P. Okay, now all these points, we can join here. We can join to the initial point O. Okay, with the help of dotted lines. Okay, so this way I am doing. Here also, okay, now this also I am joining here. Now here with the help of compass, now more than half distance PN, this is given, this distance more than half distance than this, we have to take one arc more than half distance. You will work convenient radius, we can make one arc here. We have to make one arc here, and from this point also we have to make one arc here. Okay, so now this point and this initial point we have to join. This point and initial point we are going to join here. okay. So this is 90 degree angle, this angle is 90 degree, this angle is 90 degree. Suppose I am giving here name, this is MNN. So NOA or AON is 90 degree. Okay. Now steps of constructions we can write, whatever we have done we can write, but now we need to write justification also, because they have told us and justify the construction. Okay. Once again I am repeating what we have taken. They have told us construct an angle of 90 degree at the initial point of a given ray and justify the construction. Okay. So now what we have taken first, ray OA we have taken, and O is the initial point, understood? And A we have taken one point on the ray. Okay. So from this point we have taken one arc with convenient radius, with the help of same radius with center C, make a arc on M, take a point on this arc. Okay. That point is given M, name is given M. With the help of same radius from this point take one more arc which will intersect, so that is that point we have taken P. Okay. Now this distance, more than half distance take, and from point P make one arc. Okay. And from this point make one arc and join this here, so you will get this is exactly 90 degree, understood? You can measure with your compass also, protractor also. Okay. So now here we are going to write steps of constructions, steps of constructions we need to write, and finally we will justify this steps of construction. First step, what we have done first, initially take ray OA, take ray OA. Okay. Then O is the initial point, so second step, from initial point O, take a arc with convenient radius, take a arc with convenient radius, take a arc with convenient radius. Okay. Third step what we have taken, C as a center, convenient radius. Okay. It will intersect, give name for intersection, that is point C. Okay. Then after that, as center C with same radius take a arc on the curve. Okay. This is curve and here we have taken an arc. Okay. With the help of same radius, after that with same radius, take one more arc from point M. Okay. M, that point is P. Okay. That point we have taken P. With same radius, whatever radius we have taken here, with the same radius take one arc, more arc from point M, and that is point P. Okay. Now PM, sixth step is more than half distance of PM, take arc from point P and M. Okay. Here that we have taken, that point we got M here. Okay. So let that point be, that point is N. Okay. Now join NO, seventh step is, that is last step, join NO. So angle NOA, angle NOA is equal to 90 degree. This angle is 90 degree. This will be 90 degree. Now here we have to justify. We have to justify this construction or this steps of constructions. We have to justify how we got 90 degree. Okay. Now see here. If you'll observe here one triangle we have, that is triangle MOC. Okay. In triangle MOC, see, we have this radius and this radius is same, equal. Why? By construction, that only radius we have taken. Okay. So triangle MOC is a equilateral triangle. Triangle MOC is a equilateral triangle. Okay. So we can say here CM, MO and OC are equal. Okay. So CM is equals to MO is equals to OC are equal, because equilateral triangle, all sides are equal. So this is equilateral triangle by construction. What is the reason? By construction. Okay. Because radius we have taken. Now if this is equilateral triangle, so definitely all the angles are 60 degree. 60 is 60, so this is 60 degree. Okay. This is 60 degree. Now here if we can join this also, so again you will get one more triangle. So in triangle POM, in triangle PMO, again the same radius we have taken. This radius is equals to this and this is equal. Okay, if you'll see, you will get this distance and this distance, equidistant points are there. So in this triangle is also PMO, triangle PMO is also a equilateral triangle. Okay, so here also we can say OM is equals to MP is equals to PO. OM is equals to MP is equals to PO. Okay, so definitely this is also an equilateral triangle. So angles are 60 degree. This is 60, this is 60, but this is bisected. Okay, due to ON, angle POM is bisected. Okay, due to OM, angle ON, angle POM is bisected. POM is bisected. Okay, so we can see here angle MON is equals to 30 degree. Angle MON, NOP is equal to 30 degree. Angle MON is equals to angle NOP. Angle NOP is equals to 30 degree. Okay, so this is 30 degree and this is also 30 degree. This is 30 degree and this is 30 degree. So totally 60 plus 30 is 90 degree. Okay, so this way we can justify. So now we got here, see, 60 degree, 30 degree is 90 degree. So we can see here, finally we can see here angle AON is equals to angle AOM plus NOM. Angle AOM plus angle NOM. Okay. So AOM is 60 degree and this angle is 30 degree. So 60 plus 30 is equals to 90 degree. Okay. So this is the justification. Understood? So in steps of constructions, you can write by your own. You have to write by your own whatever you have done. Okay, so that only you have to explain here. Okay, justifications you have to give with the proper reasons. So why we have taken that is equilateral triangle? Because that is all sides are equal. Why equal? Due to constructions. That way only we have done construction. Okay, radius we have taken same. So this is the construction according to the given question. Okay, thank you. Okay, see here, next construction is construct an angle of 90 degree at the initial point of a given ray and justify the construction. Okay, see here once again I am reading question. Construct an angle of 90 degree at the initial point of a ray and justify the construction. Okay, so here first we need to take a ray. Okay, so I am going to take that is okay. So here suppose I will say here this is O and this is A, ray OA. OA. Now what they have told us, construct an angle of 90 degree at the initial point of a given ray. This is initial point. Okay, this is initial point. Understood? Ray and justify the construction. Means here we have to prepare a 90 degree angle. Okay, so now here see, we have seen this also. Okay, suppose you will extend this line and you will make arc both the sides and you can construct here 90 degree. But now we are going to do with some different method. Okay, so see here carefully. We are going to do here one arc, okay, with convenient radius from point O. Okay, so from this I am going to make one arc with convenient radius. Okay, so I am doing here that arc which is intersecting ray OA at a point, we will give that point C. This point is C. Okay, now from with the help of same radius, whatever radius we have taken for this to make this arc, with the help of same radius we have to mark on the arc. Okay, make a point, fixed point, and make an arc here. Understood? So now here you got one point, you have one point. That point, suppose I am giving here name M. That point is, we will say this point is M. Okay, now with the help of same radius we are going to make one arc. Okay, this is not enough, so I am increasing that because still the radius is same. Okay, what we have done, we have taken one arc with the help of same radius, we have to take one arc on the same curve. Again with the help of same radius you will take one arc here. We will take one arc here. Okay, now we will give here name P. This is point P. This is point P. Okay, now all these points we can join here. We can join to the initial point O. Okay, with the help of dotted lines. Okay, so this way I am doing. Here also, okay, now this also I am joining here. Now here with the help of compass, now more than half distance PN, this is given, this distance more than half distance than this, we have to take one arc more than half distance. You will got convenient radius, we can make one arc here. We have to make one arc here, and from this point also we have to make one arc here. Okay, so now this point and this initial point we have to join. This point and initial point we are going to join here. Okay, so this is 90 degree angle. This angle is 90 degree. Suppose I am giving here name, this is MNN. So NOA or AON is 90 degree. Okay, now steps of constructions we can write, whatever we have done we can write, but now we need to write justification also because they have told us and justify the construction. Okay, once again I am repeating what we have taken. They have told us construct an angle of 90 degree at the initial point of a given ray and justify the construction. Okay, so now what we have taken first, ray OA we have taken, and O is the initial point, understood? And A we have taken one point on the ray. Okay, so from this point we have taken one arc with convenient radius. With the help of same radius with center C, make a arc on M, take a point on this arc. Okay, that point is given M, name is given M. With the help of same radius from this point, take one more arc which will intersect. So that is that point we have taken P. Okay, now this distance, more than half distance take, and from point P make one arc. Okay, and from this point make one arc and join this here. So you will get, this is exactly 90 degree. Understood? You can measure with your compass also, protractor also. Okay, so now here we are going to write steps of constructions we need to write, and finally we will justify this steps of construction. First step, what we have done first, initially take ray OA. Okay, then O is the initial point, so second step, from initial point O, take a arc with convenient radius. Take a arc with convenient radius. Okay. Third step, what we have taken? C as a center, convenient radius. Okay. It will intersect. Give name for intersection, that is point C. Okay, then after that, as center C with same radius, take a arc on the curve. Okay, this is curve, and here we have taken an arc. Okay, with the help of same radius, after that with same radius, take one more arc from point M. Okay, M, that point is P. Okay, that point we have taken P. With same radius, whatever radius we have taken here, with the same radius, take one arc, more arc from point M, and that is point P. Okay, now PM. Sixth step is more than half distance of PM, take arc from point P and M. Okay, here that we have taken, that point we got M here. Okay, so let that point be, that point is N. Okay, now join NO. Seventh step is, that is last step, join NO. So angle NOA is equal to 90 degree. This angle is 90 degree. This will be 90 degree. Now here we have to justify. We have to justify this construction or this steps of constructions. We have to justify how we got 90 degree. Okay. Now see here, if you'll observe here one what triangle we have, that is triangle MOC. Okay, in triangle MOC, triangle MOC, see, we have this radius and this radius is same, equal. Why? By construction, that only radius we have taken. Okay, so triangle MOC, triangle MOC is a equilateral triangle, is a equilateral triangle, equilateral triangle. Triangle MOC is a equilateral triangle. Okay, so we can say here CM, MO and OC are equal. Okay, so CM is equals to MO is equals to OC are equal, because equilateral triangle all sides are equal. So this is equilateral triangle by construction. What is the reason? By construction. Okay, because radius we have taken. Now if this is equilateral triangle, so definitely all the angles are 60 degree. 60 is 60. So this is 60 degree. Okay, this is 60 degree. Now here if we can join this also, so again you will get one more triangle. So in triangle POM, in triangle PMO, in triangle PMO, again the same radius we have taken. This is the, this radius is equals to this and this is equal. Okay, if you will see, you will get this distance and this distance, equidistant points are there. So in this triangle is also PMO, triangle PMO is also a equilateral triangle, equilateral triangle. Okay, so here also we can say OM is equals to MP is equals to PO. OM is equals to OM is equals to MP is equals to PO. Okay, so definitely this is also an equilateral triangle, so angles are 60 degree. This is 60, this is 60, but this is bisected, this is bisected. Okay, due to ON, angle POM is bisected. Okay, due to OM, angle ON, angle POM is bisected, POM is bisected. Okay, so we can see here angle MON is equals to 30 degree, angle MON, NOP is equal to 30 degree, angle MON is equals to angle NOP, angle NOP is equals to 30 degree. Okay, so this is 30 degree and this is also 30 degree, this is 30 degree and this is 30 degree. So totally 60 plus 30 is 90 degree. Okay, so this way we can justify. So now we got here, see, 60 degree, 30 degree is 90 degree. So we can see here, finally we can see here angle AON, angle AON is equals to angle AOM plus NOM, angle AOM plus angle NOM. Okay, so AOM is 60 degree and this angle is 30 degree. So 60 plus 30 is equals to 90 degree. Okay, so this is the justification. Understood? So in steps of constructions, you can write by your own. You have to write by your own whatever you have done. Okay, so that only you have to explain here. Okay, justifications you have to give with the proper reasons. So why we have taken that is equilateral triangle? Because that is all sides are equal. Why equal? Due to constructions. That way only we have done construction. Okay, radius we have taken same. So this is the construction according to the given question. Okay, thank you.